Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the love reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for the month of February 2020. So let's get right into your reading, Aries. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys. We've already shuffled the deck for time purposes, so let's get right into your reading. Now, your first card here, Aries, is the Magician card. So I see a lot of you guys trying to create or bring about that which your heart desires. For some of you guys, you may be waiting on some type of manifestation in regards to love and romance. Now, the challenge here is the Page of Pentacles. So as a challenge, the Page of Pentacles is, of course, it's talking about being patient for some of you guys. Again, connected to relationships as well as stability. So I feel that for the month of February, a lot of you guys are going to almost experience this type of energy where your financial stability is connected to your love life. So for some of you guys, it could be meeting a person in your work space. For those of you guys that have been single for a while, while for others of you, it could represent wanting to look forward to stabilizing some type of situation regarding a relationship, but it's based off of your finances. So for some, it could be the thought or the idea of wanting to, you know, commit, but you're waiting for that precise moment in time where you feel financially stable. Now, the past and passing, you guys were dealing with an air sign, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. Queen of Swords also signifies, again, being very methodical, being too much in your head, Aries. I think for a lot of you guys, this could have been a challenge as communication with the Page of Pentacles could have been a little bit withdrawn or perhaps not communicative as you would want. Now, this could be you or this could be the energy of your partner. Now, in your coming future, you do have the Three of Wands here. So there is expansion and growth. For some of you guys, there could be travel involved in regards to love and romance, especially those of you guys that are currently on a mission when it comes to the company or the career path that you're on and you're single. What they are highlighting here is that love and romance will be very much involved when it comes to the workspace. So again, don't be surprised if someone new comes into the workspace or where you work, where there may be a connection that very sexual, high attraction. But I do feel that this person is definitely going to be very interested in you. With the Three of Wands, I do see short journey, I should say. So for some of you guys, it could be going on a trip. For others of you, it could be hoping or wanting to meet someone that perhaps is at distance for you guys. Now, you do have the Strength card here, and this is what's unfolding, what you don't see coming towards you. Strength card speaks a lot about believing in yourself and being confident, knowing the truth, or raising your vibration and stop so much doubting yourself. Now, the Advice card here is the Three of Swords, and I feel that this is residue energy. So what they're telling you, Aries, is that for the month of February, it's going to be very important for you to completely let go of things that have been done or have been experienced in the past when it comes to relationships. I think that for a lot of you guys, especially those that have been single for quite a while, perhaps this is a defensive mechanism for you. Maybe that's the reason why you tend to pull or be more interested in temporary satisfaction. And what they're telling you here is with the Three of Swords, there is a need, as an advice, there is a need to stop picking at the wound, stop picking, making yourself purposely bleed from something from the past. You got to let go of that in order to be able to move forward. Stop holding that or whatever it is, whatever blockage that you're holding. There is a need for release, especially right now with the astrological alignments that we have. What they're telling you here is learn from your mistakes, Aries, but at the same time, don't make your heart or don't pretend that your heart is made of steel, because it's not. And ultimately, when it comes to people that you do have genuine connections with, you end up hurting yourself by coming off a bit distant or coming off as if you kind of push them away. And the reason for that is because ultimately there is a fear of becoming vulnerable, or there's a fear of giving your heart 100%, you know, giving it to that person or that partner, and ending up getting hurt. Ultimately, that's your fear. And what they're telling you here is you need to let go of that to be able to experience not only a new beginning, but to be able to experience the emotional connection that you're wanting or desiring. Now, the energy of the person currently influencing you, or the person you're interested in, is the Two of Swords. So there is some type of hesitation with this person. Now, for those of you guys that are currently dealing with someone that you're interested in, but it's not a relationship, they could actually be dealing with the heartbreak. And maybe that's the reason why, again, like I said, they choose to shield themselves so that they don't become vulnerable, or so they don't become able to hurt. What they're telling you here in this case is be patient. There is a need. This person is still going through that healing phase. But they will be walking away. They will be pretty much preparing themselves to actually give themselves another opportunity when it comes to love and romance. Now, if this is you still dealing with a past relationship, what they're telling you here is you need to look at the things for what they really are. Stop fantasizing. Stop giving them the benefit of the doubt. If it's not working out and it hasn't worked out in the past, it's time you walk away with this Eight of Cups here. Now, you do have the Empress card. The Empress card does signify abundance. It also speaks about fertility, but not just fertility in the physical aspect. This could be in an emotional aspect as well. What they're telling you is, you know, a lot of the times when we've been hurt, when we've gone through difficulties, we kind of protect ourselves, creating this, you know, transparent, or I should say, this shield around us or around our heart, because we obviously don't want to go through the same. But what they are telling you is you need to understand that not everyone is going to treat you or is going to do bad by you, and you need to give them that opportunity to prove themselves to you through actions, not through words. So I hope this helps you. I hope it gives you some type of guidance, and we will see each other soon. Talk to you then. Bye.